Hey guys, it's Katie here with Life the Mundane, and welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you guys 10 of our favorite Christmas picture books. Now, there are picture books for all ages here. There are one from your tots up to your older kids, and I'm so excited to share them with you today. So, let's get started. Hi, my name is Katie, and welcome to Life the Mundane. I am second-generation homeschool mom of six beautiful kiddos, and on this channel, we talk all things resources. I love to share with you resources that are going to help you in your homeschooling and help encourage you in your biblical parenting and how you can utilize those to their fullest potential so that you can make the most of the little moments. Today's video is actually done in collaboration with my friend Rachel over from 7&All. Rachel is not only an amazing YouTube and content creator, she also actually owns the company called Where'd You Learn That with her and her siblings. They create quality curriculum for homeschoolers on a budget. They make our preschool curriculum that we use with our little ones. But the other thing we love about Rachel is she has actually created a Christmas unit that we will be using this Christmas. I have done a video on it, just kind of a flip through, letting you guys know more information about it. I will drop that down in the description below, so be sure to check that out. But in the spirit of getting in the holiday season, let's get started with the books. Our first book is Mistletoe. We absolutely love this book. It is a fun, silly story all about a moose family who is decorating for Christmas but finds himself without a Christmas tree. They've gone all over town and cannot find a tree, but they find that these fun mooses with these extra long mustaches might just have a little creative idea on how to create their own Christmas tree. This one will have you laughing as you see the moose styling, decorating his mustache to help his parents have the perfect Christmas. Next up is The Jolly Postman. If you guys saw my recent thrift book and book outlet haul, if you didn't, I'll link it up above and down in the description below, but you probably saw this book. It is seriously a huge favorite. It's all about a postman who is delivering letters to popular fairy tale characters. And each time he delivers a letter, you will see a letter on the page. But when you flip the page, you actually get to open it up and inside see what that fairy tale character got. This is a board game that one of the characters got. And so your kids can actually play the board game. It even has instructions for them. And Humpty Dumpty gets his own Humpty Dumpty puzzle. So it says Humpty Dumpty's falls to bits. Put them together and let's see how he fits. The story is cute and sweet, but definitely will also have your kids super interested as they open up and see each surprise in each letter. Number three on our list is My Christmas List. This is seriously one of my all-time favorites. I absolutely love this book. It is written by a child here in America, and he is writing his Christmas list. But instead of wishing for the latest toy or the latest gadgets, he is actually wishing for different people in other countries to have a better life. Praying for kids whose parents are sick in Uganda, or for those in Guatemala who don't have clean drinking water, for those in Zambia who don't have any food. All of it is really awesome, and I love to read this to my kids. And the book, the best part about this book is it ends by praying that each one of these kids in these different countries gets to know Christ. This one is a really sweet one. Now, what I will say about this one, this is actually one that I featured last year in a video that I did on my five favorite Christ-centered Christmas books. I wanted to include all of those again this year in this video, but I didn't want to bore you if you'd already seen it. So be sure if you haven't seen it to check out the link up above and down in the description below so you can see those other five favorite Christmas ones. But I did want to just introduce this one as this one I feel like is a must-have. Next up is a classic, and that is How the Grinch Stole Christmas. I am not going to speak too much on this one as I'm sure you guys have seen it, but having the actual book version and getting to read it to my kids every year is one of my absolute favorites. We love to grab hot cocoa and enjoy the story about the Grinch who learned the real meaning of Christmas and how his heart grew three sizes too big. Number five is a silly favorite, and I would love to show you the actual book right now because it is seriously became one of our absolute favorites last year, but I can't find it. So I'm digging around in Christmas boxes, and I will be sure to show you guys on Instagram if I find it, but it is Porky Pine in a Pine Tree. This story is a board book. It is absolutely amazing. Yes, it's a board book, so your little ones can enjoy it, but my older kids were rolling on the floor laughing. A Porky Pine in a Pear Tree is a parody of the 12 Days of Christmas, but instead of the typical geese and swans and rings, instead you will find fun, lighthearted content that is all Canadian themed. So you'll find curlers curling, Canadian Mounties, and of course, a porcupine in a pine tree. Be sure to check out this one as this is seriously one of my favorites. And if we can't find it, I will have to rebuy it. five because it is a must. Number six is, Santa, are you for real? This one is a really good one if your kids are questioning about who is Santa Claus. Is Santa Claus for real? We do not do Santa Claus in our house, but we do read stories that he is in, and I have no problem with that. But if you're looking for a good way to talk to your kids about Santa, to help them understand everything they see around them on TV and other places, this is a great one. It's about a little boy who is hearing his friends in the neighborhood talk about Santa Claus, wondering if he is for real. So his dad sits down and tells him the true story of Saint Nicholas and how he would go around giving toys to all of the children, and how through the stories of his deeds, Santa Claus was kind of created. It also talks about how Saint Nicholas did that, and he gave gifts because God gave us the best gift of all on Christmas morning, which was Jesus. If you don't do images of Jesus, there is one in this book, but I was able to easily cover it up. So just that heads up. Number seven is The Year of the Perfect Christmas Tree. This is one that we've had on our shelf for many years, and we just really delved into last year because it does have a lot of text. It is a little overwhelming, and I would recommend reading it either over a series of days or reading it with your older kids. But it is about a sweet family in the Appalachian Mountains who goes on search for the perfect Christmas tree. The father in this story is actually one of the most endearing characters. He and his daughter go in search of the perfect Christmas tree actually in the spring, as they look to mark the tree and save it so that they know which one to go to next year. But before Christmas can come around, Papa has been sent off to war, and he is no longer there when it comes time to cut down the tree. But they faithfully go out and find the tree that he marked to cut down to save for the church Christmas pageant. Thankfully, not only are they able to find a tree, but also a special little surprise at the end. This is a heartwarming tale and something that I think your kids will really enjoy. Number eight is Bear Stays Up for Christmas. We love the Bear Stays Up books, and this one is a fun one. Bear and all of his friends are trying to stay up so that they can see Santa Claus. And even though they go through all these fun different adventures and he's trying to get the bear to stay up, ultimately, the bear ends up staying up and his friends end up falling asleep when Santa comes. This is a fun and silly favorite that my kids enjoy reading each year. Number nine, of course, is another classic favorite, and that is Little Blue Truck's Christmas. I got this one. We've always loved the Little Blue Truck books, but I got this one last year after this very collab, and I had so many people recommending it that I had to get my own copy. We had the regular Little Blue Truck and another one from the series, but not the Christmas one. This one is a fun story. It also works on counting, which is great if you have preschoolers, but just a really fun story. And at the end is the most fun part, which is a real live light up Christmas tree that your kids can enjoy. Last but not least is the Ellis Island Christmas. I actually got this book in a book outlet haul that I showed earlier this year. We had gotten it from the library and read it and really enjoyed it, so I wanted our own copy. This one is really great if you are looking for some historical Christmas favorites. It's about a little girl who comes overseas, she's immigrating, and she ends up on Ellis Island. It talks about her experience on the boat, her fears and her concerns coming to a new country, and how she's reunited with her family during Christmas on Ellis Island. Really sweet story, and I think you guys will enjoy it, especially if you are studying this historical time period in your school. Well, that's all we've got for today, but be sure to subscribe because coming up on Saturday, I will actually be having a Q&A wrap and chat with my husband, and we have a really big announcement to give you guys. No, I'm not pregnant, but we do have something really fun we want to share with you, so be sure to subscribe and check out the playlist down below to see all the other great YouTubers that are out there, and we'll talk to you later. Bye!